look at the coffin with golden handles. Isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead? Let's not have a snivel. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you bloody will die.
Look at the moon. Isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead?
Let's not have a snivel. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you bloody will die.
Look at the flowers. Bloody well dead.
Let's not have a snivel. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you bloody will die.
Look at the preacher, bloody sanctimonious. Isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead?
Let's not have a snivel. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you bloody well die.
Look at the waiter. Bloody great female, isn't it grand, boys, to be bloody well dead?
Let's not have a snivel. Let's have a bloody good cry. And always remember, the longer you live, the sooner you bloody well die.
The last time that we four did a concert was in April 1969. That's how long ago? 15 years. And we will start off now by dedicating this first song to the men who risked their lives and their freedom on the mountains of Ireland making illegal booze. And as you all know, it's mostly known as potcheen, and it's also known as Mountain Dew, as in this next song. It's known as moonshine, red biddy, white lightning, several
holy, holy water is my favorite.
Here's a song about Mountain Dew.
Let grasses grow and waters flow in a free and easy way, but give me enough of the fine old stuff that's made near Galway Bay. And policemen all from Donegal, Sligo and Leeds from two, we'll give them the sip and we'll take a sip of the real old Mountain Dew.
Up to the sky. By the smoke and the smell, you can plainly tell that there's potcheen growing nearby. It fills the air with odor rare, and betwixt both me and you, when home you stroll, you can take a bowl and a bucket at the Mountain Dew.
Hi, diddly 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 didd
the gypsy rover, come over the hill. Down through the valley so shady, he whistled and he sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of a lady.
Let's hear. Ah-dee-doo, 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 ah-dee-doo. He whistled and he sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of a lady.
She left her father's castle gate, she left her own fond lover, she left her servants and her state to follow the gypsy rover.
Ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-doo, da-dee, ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-dee. He whistled and he sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of the lady.
Her father saddled up his fastest steed, roamed the valleys all over, sought his daughter at great speed, and the whistling gypsy rover.
Ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-doo, da-dee, ah-dee-doo, ah-dee-dee. He whistled and he sang till the green woods rang, and he won the heart of the lady.
He came at last to a mansion fine, down by the river so shady, and there was music and there was wine for the gypsy and his lady.
You're on your own, let's eat.
The job.
He is no gypsy, my father, she said, but lord of these lands all over, and I will stay till my dying day with my whistling gypsy roll.
Last chance, here you go.
There was a Dublin street ballad in the last century that found its way into the music halls of Dublin. A song called Finnegan's Wake. James Joyce, the author, was fascinated by this song. Most of us just thought of it as another drinking song. The fella dies, is laid out, whiskey spills on him, the water of life, and needless to say, he rises from the dead. What else would he do? Right, the rest of us could see it as a pleasant little song, fun at a party. Joyce saw in it the entire cycle of life, death, resurrection of the whole universe.
Tim Finnegan lived in Walker Street, a gentle Irishman, mighty eye. He had a broad coat, rich and sweet, and a rise in the world he carried a heart. You see, in a sort of a tipper's way, with a lot with a liquor for Tim was bought. To help him on with his work each day, he was round with a prayer every morning.
One morning Tim felt rather full, his head felt heavy, which made him shake. He fell from the ladder and he broke his skull, and they carried him home as corpse to wake. They rolled him up in a nice clean sheet, and they laid him out upon the bed. with a bucket of whiskey at his feet and a bottle of porter at his head. What for the night of this year, partner, with the boat of your smartly. What an infant fruit, they told him lots of fun and Finnegan's wake. His friends assembled at the wake and Mrs. Finnegan called for lunch. For she brought in tea and cake, then pipes, tobacco and whiskey punch. Biddy O'Brien began to cry, such a nice clean corpse did you ever see? Tim McBonin, why did you die? Or shut your mouth, says Paddy McGee.
Right on the line, oh, that's dear partner, what the boy is trying to shake. What a day, that's how you love some fun and Finnegan way.
And Maggie O'Connor took up the job. Oh, Biddy, says she, you're wrong, I'm sure. Biddy gave her a belt in the gob and she left her sprawling on the floor. Then the war did soon engage, woman to woman and man to man. Shillelagh law was all the rage, and her own eruption soon began.
What for the night, that's the abandoner, what the boy had turned. What a day, the truth they told you, lots of fun and Finnegan way.
Then Mickey Maloney raised his head, when the bucket of whiskey flew at him. It missed and fallen on the bed, the liquor scattered over Tim. You got here a wife, see how he rises. Timothy rising from the bed, saying, hurl your whiskey around like phrases. Thundering Jesus, do you think I'm dead?
Like for the lad who does your master with the boy you're trying to see. What an end, they told you lots of fun and Finnegan's wake.
He stumbled home from Clifton Fair with drunken song and cheeks aglow, yet there was something in his air that told of kingship long ago. I turned and inly burned with grief that one so high should fall so low. But he plucked a flower and sniffed its scent and waved it toward the sunset sky. Some old sweet rapture through him went and kindled in his bloodshot eye. I sighed and inly cried for joy that one so low should rise so high.
I wish I was in Carrickfergus, only for nights in Ballygran. I would swim over the deepest ocean, the deepest ocean, my love to find. The sea is wide and I can't swim over, and neither have I wings to fly. I wish I could meet a handsome boatman to ferry me over to my love and die. Ah, but in Kilkenny it is reported of marble stones there as
black as ink. With gold and silver I did support her. But I'll sing no more until I get a drink. I'm drunk today and I'm self sober, and some rover from town to town. Ah, but I'm sick. My days are numbered. Come all you young men and lay me down.
I was a little boy, so my mother told me, Jimmy,
way Holloway, well Holloway show,
that if I did not kiss the girls, my lips would all grow moldy. Jimmy,
way Holloway, well Holloway show,
no
way. Ship now is rolling, Jimmy, way Holloway, well Holloway, Joe.
King Louis was the king of France before the revolution.
Way Holloway, well Holloway, Joe.
And then he got his head cut off, it spoiled his constitution.
Way Holloway, well Holloway, Joe.
No, first I met a Yankee girl, and she was fat and lazy. Jimmy,
way Holloway, well Holloway, Joe.
And then I met an Irish girl, she damn near drove me crazy. Jimmy,
way Holloway, well Holloway, Joe.
No
way Holloway, we're bound for better weather.
Jimmy,
way Holloway, well Holloway, Joe.
We have no intention of leaving you without singing this one, and it says no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more. Will I play the Wild Rover? No, never, no more.
Never. And it's no, nay, never.
Bye.
And I told the landlady me money was spent. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. Such a custom as yours I can get any day.
And it's no
I took sovereigns bright, and the landlady's eyes opened wide with delight. She said, I have whiskey and wines of the best, and the words that I said sure were only in jest.
And it's no name.
You're looking at four of them. They're traveling people. They have no homes to go to ever. But anyway, here's a song about one of the tinker ladies. They called her Red-Haired Mary.
While going to the fair of Dingle, one fine morning last July, when going down the road before me, a red-haired girl I chanced to spy. I went up to her, said I, young lady, my donkey he will carry too. Well, seeing as how you have a donkey, to the Dingle Fair I'll ride with you. Now when we reached the town of Dingle, I had took her hand to say goodbye. When a tinker man stepped up beside me, and he belted me in my left eye.
Keep your hands off Red-Haired Mary, her and I will soon be wed. We'll see the priest this very morning, tonight we'll lie in a married bed.
I was feeling kind of peevish, and me poor all I was sad and sore. And I gently tapped him with me hobnails, and he flew back through Murphy's door.
Keep your hands up, Red-Haired Mary, or I will soon be there. We'll see the priest this
policeman came around the corner and he told me I had broke the law. When the donkey kicked him in the kneecap and he fell down and broke his jaw.
Keep your hands up, Red Mary, or I will soon be wet. We'll see the priest this very morning tonight. We'll lie on my bed.
Then he went off to find his brother, the biggest man you ever did meet. And he tapped me gently with his knuckles, and I was minus two front teeth.
Keep your hands up, Red Mary, or I will soon be red. We'll see the priest this very morning tonight. We'll lie in a married bed.
Now the red-haired girl, she kept on smiling. I will go with you, young man, she said. We'll forget the priest this very morning, and tonight we'll lie in Murphy's shed.
Keep your hands up, Red Mary, or I will soon be wet. We'll forget the priest this very morning, tonight we'll lie in Murphy's shed.
Now through the fair we're all together, fair black eye and her red hair, smiling gaily at the tinkers, and begot we were a handsome pair.
Keep your hands up, Red Mary, or I will soon be with. We'll forget the priest this very morning, and tonight we'll lie in Murphy's shed.
We're going to sing a song, it's an old favourite. It's the one we learned from an old man in Ireland. An old man whose whole life had been sweetened by the drinking of punch. And he... he ground it out for us one night, just before closing time. He'd been drinking all day. And he growled it out as the world was slipping out of focus for him. We'd like you to join us in a jug of punch.
One pleasant evening in the month of June, as I was sitting with my glass and spoon, a small bird sat on an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. Tooraloo-ra-loo, tooraloo-ra-lay, tooraloo-ra-loo, tooraloo-ra-lay. A small bird sat down an ivy bunch, and the song he sang was the jug of punch. What more devotion can a man desire than to sit him down by a snug tar fire? Upon his knee a pretty wench, aye, and on the table a jug of punch. Tooraloo-ra-loo, tooraloo-ra-lay, tooraloo-ra-loo, tooraloo-ra-lay. Upon his knee a pretty wench, aye, and on the table a jug of punch. Let the doctors come with all their art, they'll make no impression upon my heart. Even the cripple forgets his hunch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch. Tooraloo-ra-loo, tooraloo-ra-lay, tooraloo-ra-loo, tooraloo-ra-lay. Even the cripple forgets his hunch when he's snug outside of a jug of punch. And if I get drunk, well, the money's me own, and them don't like me, they can leave me alone. I'll chum me fiddle and I'll rosin me bow, and I'll be welcome wherever I go. Do-ra-loo-ra-loo, do-ra-loo-ra-loo.
We're very much indebted to the people who went to see, the men and the women. They left us some of the greatest songs that we ever sang. And one of the most singable and lovely sea songs came out in this last sort of folk revival in the 1960s in England. A song called The Leaving of Liverpool, and you all know the chorus on it, so sing it with us.
There was a wild colonial boy, Jack Devon.
left his native home. And to Australia's sunny shore he was inclined to roam. He robbed the rich, he helped the poor, he shot James McAvoy.
A terror to Australia was the wild colonial boy.
One morning on the prairie, as Jackie rode along, a listening to the mockingbird, a singing a cheerful song, up stepped a band of trooper, Kelly Davis and Fitzroy.
Our actors, as I foretold you, are all spirits and are melted into air, into thin air. And like the baseless fabric of this vision, the cloud-capped palaces, the gorgeous towers, the solemn temples, the
the great globe itself. Yea, all which they inherit shall dissolve, and like they did, leave not a rack behind. We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with a sleep. But I'm asking you in Shakespeare's words is, have you no homes to go to?
The summertime is coming,
and the trees,
and are sweetly blooming.
Oh, the summertime is coming, and the trees are sweetly blooming, and the wild mountain thyme grows around the blooming heather. Will your old lassie go? And we'll all go together to the wild mountain thyme, all around the blooming heather. Will your old lassie go?
I will build my love a bower near yon pure crystal fountain, and on it I will pile all the flowers of the mountain. Will you go, lassie, go?
And we'll all go together to the wild and the wild mountain thyme, and the wild